Hi, welcome back to the Shtick. This is the end of the beginning of our 62nd season, and to help us celebrate this very momentous occasion, we have with us a young man with a huge future, and his name is Mordechai Aryeh Levin. Hi, Mordi.
Hey.
What's going on?
Lots of painting.
You're just stuck at home painting?
At the moment, yes, and just preparing for Yomim Noraim.
Right. That's going to be next month in September. You're talking about the high holidays.
Yes.
Because you've been a Chazzan now at Elwood Shule for a while until they closed down.
Yes, I was meant to be traveling most of the time, but because of COVID, I probably got a month and a half in to my year, and then I had to return back home.
Right. And we wanted just to talk to you about your art more than anything else, because besides being a Chazzan and you've had training in opera and you've worked in different fields in different synagogues as a Chazzan, which we have to explain to our audience who don't know what a Chazzan is. What's a Chazzan?
It's a cantor. It's a leader of services in a synagogue setting.
Right. And so that's your main gig. But the thing that you're really passionate about is your art. And we have to talk about that.
Sure. Deserve credit.
So what makes you want to pursue this wonderful thing that you do?
I have, for as long as I can remember, I've always been the creative type, whether that's musically or artistically, like in terms of fine arts.
Uh-huh.
So it's been a lifetime of development and will be a lifetime of development going forwards. So that's my journey with art, really. It started from kindergarten. My mother still has, you know, sketches of mine from when I was in kindergarten and you know, even when I was a toddler and so on and so forth. So,
yeah, so you've developed that into a Jewish thematic kind of thing where you paint something that is symbolic of our festivals. For example, Purim, Shavuot, Pesach. And you're working on bigger pieces now. You've got something behind you there.
Yes. This will be a very big piece. This is about a meter by a meter and a half long. And it's a painting depicting the splitting of the sea. That's Yom Suf.
The Exodus.
Yes. Uh-huh. And there's still a bit to go on it, but the bulk of it is pretty much complete. It's just the clothing will have a few more extra touches done.
Right. You never know. The thing with art is you never know when to finish it exactly. There's always more to do, isn't there?
Very much so. And because my art is so detailed and there's so many little components to it, if it doesn't flow, if the theme doesn't flow entirely, then there seems to be something missing. So that's why I'm so adamant as to completing the final touches on the clothing, because if that is missing, it almost isn't mine. It almost doesn't look like the rest.
Right.
And I'm trying my very best to find a style that is recognizable.
Yes, well, you've just done a painting called Daniel in the Lion's Den, which I think, talking about detail, the detail in that is like the mosaic is extraordinary.
Yes, I love that Byzantine, Cretan kind of vibe that you know, that I very much look to when I paint. And it comes across in that mosaic detail, and I use certain gold stylings as well to create that shine and that glass effect. And I also usually paint little squares, and I don't know if you can see them, but different types of squares for different things. So anything but water, it will be just squares, little squares. And then after I paint all these little squares, I fill each and every square with a different color.
Wow, that's amazing. You also have done a painting called Am Israel Chai, which is like a reflection of your overall love for Judaism and anything to do with Israel.
Sure, definitely. I very much connect with that. I come from a very proud Zionist family, and we're big supporters of Israel, and also the lion, both in the Lion's Den, Daniel in the Lion's Den, and also in Am Yisrael Chai, the actual thought came from my name. I know that sounds quite egotistical, but when I looked into the essence of my name, and Aryeh, which is middle name,
which means lion.
Lion.
Yeah.
I thought, what better a way to start this new style, this new collection, this concrete style that I've got going on, by opening up with something that not only relates to the Jewish religion and to the Jewish people and to the Jewish culture, but also to me.
Yeah, it's a very personal thing. Well, it's been really great to get you on the shtick, because I've seen you perform. I filmed you, in fact, for Bet Raphael, when Shimon Allen asked me to do a whole bunch of chazunas with different rabbis doing their singing. I met you there personally, and I was very impressed with your singing. We must also mention, just as a thought, that Bet Raphael really needs support at this time, because they do an amazing job. But I'd like to go out with a video that was taken of you singing a Toorak Shule, which is just a short bit. But we're looking forward to the new year, which is going to be challenging. But always we'll overcome every challenge, won't we, Mordi?
That we hope so. I mean, it's been a tough time for everyone, and hopefully things will get better soon.
Definitely. Okay, well, we're going now with you singing a little bit of your chazonis, and I'd like to wish you all the very best, and thank you for coming on the shtick with us.
Thank you for having me.
Say shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Oh,